If you stand even the American Constitution, it has been amended over time with the intention of addressing the challenges of that time. When there was serious discrimination in America, racial discrimination, where blacks could not do this, they could do elections, even women. You know, people don't understand, people think some of the rights we have here are obvious. In some countries, they were not obvious. In America, women could not vote until very recently. Civil rights movement come, then it has to be amended. Because there's a crisis. You are sustaining a system that is discriminative, that is oppressive. It is corrected, it addresses the challenge of that time. So we have a challenge as a nation. Because we have elections that are violent. Every electoral cycle, we must address that. Sasa ukituambia wewe si hiyo, si nini, COVID just came, it will go away. We are fighting it. Dealing with the constitution does not stop you from fighting COVID. I mean, those two issues, how are they related? I mean, how does an issue that threatens the very existence of the nation become an issue because there is a pandemic? How does it become an issue? So even as we deal with the pandemic, we must also deal with the national challenges that cause us problems that also bring death, like pandemic brings. Tunaelewana? And I think we can do that. We can raise enough resources to deal with the pandemic. The challenges, this pandemic is everywhere. Even in America, they are dealing with it. Did they stop elections?
No.
they had to have an election. Now, I can imagine somebody going to argue there. The last election, maybe Trump would, to serve his own interest, would have told them, no, we postponed these elections because we have a serious national crisis. We don't need the elections. It's the same argument that is being pushed around by short-termists. People only look at an election as an end in itself. They don't look at the survival of this country and this nation as an important issue to deal with. They must deal with it. I really don't want to go back. Tumeelezwa, tumeelewa, na nafikiri mmesema mnaunga mkono. Kwa hivyo mkienda sasa hawa media waone kama mmeunga mkono. Si tuone kwa mikono basi. Watu wa kamera muone huko. Mulika kila mahali, marafiki wa PNU na PNU, sisi sote tunafanya nini? Tunaunga mkono. Hiyo ni moja, ya pili ni kuunga mkono.
Hata handshake tunaunga mkono.
Na handshake pia tunaunga mkono.
Ndio yote.
Tunaunga mkono.
Bas, na sio kuunga mkono pekee. Sasa tuende nyumbani kwetu huko. Tuwe trainers. Tuwe educators. Wa kuhakikisha kule tumetoka tu watu wameunga mkono. Huko Masabit tulikuwa huko, hata Isiolo tutaenda. Hata Tanariba tulikuwa tumepanga. Tuende pamoja huko kila eneo la Kenya. Tukiunga BBI nini? Mkono. Na wale wamepotea wala hawaelewi. Tuwalete, tuwarudishe. Sometimes people want to use problems sile tuko nazo to incite the public against a good thing. Oh, vijana wana kazi. Yes, vijana wana kazi, kuna shinda ya economy which requires to be addressed. And that challenge is a long-term one. It's not instant. It's not like you can say abracadabra and all jobs are created and every young person in this country is employed. You have to look at a trajectory. And the stability, national stability is a key element in growing an economy to absorb people, to give them jobs. So kama every election cycle, Nairobi inakwama. Uwezi fika mahali. Wakati mwingine hata violence huko Rift Valley na wapi. Economy inasorota kabisa, inarudi huko nyuma. Unaanza kujenga tena. Utakreate jobs na mna gani vijana wapate kazi? Ama utakreate na kuwapea wiruba? How can a wheelbarrow generate? Wheelbarrow is a tool. And of course, there are better tools also available. Wheelbarrow si mbaya, natumika kwa mjengo na nzuri. Siasa tu.
Anakuja na ndege unapeana wili wako.
Sasa wheelbarrow na hata tu zingine lazima kuwe kuna ile kazi itafanya nini? Kwa hivyo lazima upanue economy ndio kazi ya wheelbarrow ya ile mashine nyingine hata ya loan muwa na ya nini ipatikane.